We expect growth momentum to remain strong in the Asia-Pacific region, supported by solid domestic demand and rising world trade. Fiscal policies are geared toward increases in infrastructure spending, and monetary conditions remain lax thanks to low inflation. In Japan, evidence is mounting that the BOJ's exceptional monetary easing is gaining traction. We expect growth of around 1.5% in 2017 and more or less to continue into 2018. Among the largest improvements to growth we project are for India and Indonesia. India's growth should improve as headwinds from reform implementation fade, and Indonesia should benefit from firming commodity prices. An exception to this pickup is China. Tighter credit conditions aimed at curbing financial risks will weigh on its housing market. Nevertheless, we expect the slowdown to be mild, with growth easing from 6.8% in 2017 to 6.4% in 2018. Any dampening effect on the rest of APAC should be offset by robust domestic demand and exports to the rest of the world. The main risks are the impact of higher U.S. interest rates and geopolitics. As labor markets tighten, we believe U.S. monetary policy will be steadily tightened, and easing will come to an end in the Eurozone. Tighter financial conditions, especially if accompanied by renewed U.S. dollar strength, could put pressure on capital inflows, asset prices, and currencies. Economies with large external financing needs and foreign currency debt, such as Indonesia and Malaysia, could feel the biggest impact. The other source of risk is geopolitics in Asia. Tensions on the Korean Peninsula are likely to remain high, which could undermine investor sentiment and provoke spillovers to international trade relations. In China, following the recent 19th Party Congress, we'll be watching for the government's willingness to ease away from high growth targets, which we believe are at the root of the economy's large increase in leverage. Finally, policy uncertainty from the U.S. administration remains a source of risk. One example is the administration's focus on bilateral trade balances, which will keep Asian trading partners on edge from the risk of protectionism.